everyone, Admiral Lemon here. We're back. That was really high-pitched. What was that? That was weird. We're back on the Flyboy server, and I'm taking a very, very long needed little break. Because the airship has finally been complete. And I think I'm gonna go with, I don't know who said this. There was one person in one of my streams, on my Twitch streams, who told me what to name it. And I forgot your name, person, so I am really sorry. I am really, really sorry. I tried to remember, but then I did not remember. So I am a horrible person for that. But it is going to be called the SS Pink Lemonade. I think that name is very fitting. Actually, like, very, extremely, very, very fitting, because that's pretty cool how Pink Lemonade kind of fits right in there. And if I sound kind of weird this morning, I'm a little sinusy, I'm a little nasal. I just got up not too long ago, and I'm completely congested. I can't even breathe through my nose at all. So there's zero nose breathing, which sucks. So if you hear me take like lots of like weird sounds out of my mouth, that's me trying to breathe while I talk. So I am sorry if I sound gross. And as always, in Flyboy's fashion, it's the heck? It's sunset as soon as I record. So what are you guys flashing? Don't flash. So before we take a little nightly snooze, today's episode, it's gonna be nothing. Nothing but me checking out the airship for you fine people and its surroundings. But first, let's take a quick little sleepy sleep. There we go. Ah, feels so good to sleep in my own bed. Well, I mean, I always sleep in my own bed in this. Never mind. Server, that sounds really bad. Wow, that water bottle had a lot of water in there as many times as I sipped on that thing. Well, there we go. We got 25 stickies. And the best way to travel up to this thing would be Goaty. But I want to give you guys a very, very good first person hands-on experience. I don't know what I'm trying to say. I'm still kind of tired. Can you guys tell? Still kind of tired. I need a little sip here of my delicious caffeine beverage. If my mother was here, or here, she would tell me that it's way too early for for soft drinks, but that's okay. Because I'm a grown adult, and I can drink what I want. I'm sorry, Mom. I love you. Okay, so let's go ahead and fill this Tegacopter up with some fuel. A lot of fuel, because I want to do a few rounds around the airship. There we go. That'll work. And let's turn you down. Yes. What are you? Friendly? You are weather hostile? Players. Ambient environment. Blocks. G-Buck notebooks. Okay. Master volume it is! That should be good. 20% should be good. Okay. Really? There's not a setting for that? Whatever. Let's just go. Okay. So let's go on the Tegacopter. Looking amazing as always. And let's go up. Let's go up and up, and let's just do a little hovering first, We're hovering. Now, a lot of you guys have probably not seen this thing, like, up close. Like I have the past, I don't know how long I've been working on this thing, a few weeks. But yeah. Now, I say it's 100% complete. It's not quite 100% complete. It's pretty much complete. There are things on here that I may or may not do or change. Like, for instance, this back hangs off quite a bit. I may add kind of a support coming for that to the air balloon part. I don't know. It's not a big deal. We may. And so here is the propeller on the back. It's kind of small, which most of the propulsion... Oh, I just said a pretty big word. Propulsion. Most of the propulsion is supposed to be made by these little things right here. Well, there's four of them, and they're not little, they're huge, it took forever to make. Yes. This is what kind of propulses. Propulses? Is that a word now? No, I think I'm just making up words. This is what's supposed to move the airship up and down and right, left, and forward and backwards and in vertical invertices. Now I am just making up words. Yes, these things here took a very, very, very long time to build because a lot of you guys know that. Okay, it's not 100%. I missed. Okay, I got it. I can fix that easily. Don't worry, guys. Crap, dang it. Anyway, as you guys know in Schematica, you can just print. You can just go to the print little button here and hit it to on, and it will print the whole thing for you. Now, what took me so long to finish these four little propulsion devices is that it doesn't differentiate between the different types of blocks. So here, these little shiny looking blocks right here, the shiny looking ones, those are all what are those called? Tyrian blocks. And these are Tyrian blocks. That's a Tyrian block. It won't differentiate between these blocks. So when you put print, it prints all Tyrian blocks the same kind. So either you have to not print it, or you have to go back with your chisel and chisel until it gets the correct block that you want. Like this. This would all print one block. This would all print one block. So a lot of this stuff I wasn't able to print. I just did it by hand, and that took a long time because this thing is pretty. How do we go? I want to go down now. This thing is fairly detailed. For an airship, these things are pretty high helicopter or tank copter, whatever. Yeah, they're pretty detailed on the bottom and the top. They're detailed everywhere. And so let's just do a nice little 360 around this puppy, so you guys can see it in its awesome gloriness. Gloriness, not goriness. It's not gory. Well, it I'm going that the right way. It could be gory. It could be gory one of these days. It could be. Why am I not? Okay, why am I not going the way I want to go? Thing. Let's go this way, please. Did I turn something on? I think I turned the wrong button on. Hold on. Yes, free look. There we go. That's what I did, stupid freaking thing. I didn't run into this mall pack. Let's go down a little bit more. I'm really bad at flying this thing. I need to practice. Because I really want to start flying these tank hoppers more often. They're easy to make. They don't take much gas. But they're really slow though. But anyway, this is the 360 round. We got our guns on the top, as you can see, looking quite amazing. Let's take a few screenshots of this puppy. A few screenshots. Guns everywhere. Now, they're not all loaded. The big guns are not loaded. The smaller, the machine guns, these machine guns are. And the little ones are always loaded. Like, they come with bullets in them, like invisible machine gun bullets. I don't know how or where, but they're there. Now, the big ones aren't loaded yet because I don't want to accidentally blow something up. So we're not going to load those until the day before the battle or amongst the battling time happens. And then we'll load these big puppies up. But let's go ahead and land this daycopter right on the deck. There we go. Perfect, as intended. And shift. And walk. And walk. And walk. And walking. We're walking. We're walking. So here's one gun. I think I've been in a lot of these guns, so I'm not going to do this too much. But yeah, we've got guns. All kinds of guns on this puppy. A lot of guns here. Now, I don't know. These shoot. Yeah. Yeah. Right? How do these things shoot? Oh, yeah. So I'm not going to use. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. So those shoot fine. We're not going to worry about these puppies. These will do plenty of damage on their own, and they look pretty amazing too. This big gun will not have any ammo until later. And this honk thing will not have any ammo until later either, because he is huge as well. And these, like I said, always. I'm fine. I'm still early. Let me just take another little sip of some caffeine. So much better. I'm so nasally though. So these always have ammo, but they do overheat very quick. But as an anti-deterrent, I think anti-air, I think these would be just fine. Just fine. And then we got one more on the behind, on the rear. Just like right there. And we got two more of these big ones, just have ammo in them, they're full right there. And this was meant to be a, I don't know, maybe like a landing pad. I don't know if a helicopter would really work here because these guns may shoot this thing. I don't know. If you got something over here and you're in these yonder machine guns, this big honking helicopter, this thing's probably gonna explode. So this may not be the best placement. Maybe more like a TIGcopter landing or a goatee landing. And we got our garage doors to lock off the area if needed. And the same thing right here. I don't know what this was. This is just sort of a thing. You can't, it'd be really cool if you could actually get in the gun from here, but you can't. It's way too big and the entrance is way too far up there. So yeah, there's that. Before we go up top, topside, let's go down into the bowels of the beast. You guys have probably seen this, maybe not, but this is the inside of the SS Pink Lemonade. And F7 will show you that it is mob safe, proof friendly. There's no yellow, there's no red anywhere. So that is good, right? That is very good, actually. I worked very hard to make that sure that was happening because I got blown here so many times, more times than I will admit ever. We've got the engine right here. Engine, I think, is very cool looking. Mm-hmm. Got the engine with the pink powder, the Team Pink. And the back part here, as you can see, this is where the propeller is being powered from for. Mm-hmm. And all the tubing and wires that are going out into the big thing, fan blade things. They should be called big fans on the outside. Are all coming from the bottom of the engine and flowing around. And yeah, you guys get it. You guys get it. And you can actually walk this path all the way to the end. All the way to the end. I can't believe I made it. I hardly ever make that jump. It's amazing. It's a Christmas miracle. All the way to the end and out. Out of the front hole of the vessel, which is kind of disturbing. But I really like the inside. I think this would be a really cool place to hide to put a pink diamond and to do some firefighting. Some pew, 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 pew. Of course, my vessel is going to get completely annihilated, but that's okay. Yep, I know this, guys. I know the wool will catch fire. I am aware of it. I am expecting it. It's not a big deal because then you have guns and missiles and flaming shooters around. Things are gonna get destroyed, and I am okay with that. That's part of the Flyboys motto. It's okay that things are gonna get destroyed and killed and murdered. I forget my ladder was gone now. This is gonna be a long way down. So, which is why I made these little, I guess you call them escape areas right here at the bottom. Let's go ahead and do a quick little jumpy jump because it is nighttime and I do not want to die on this day to a creeper blowing me or a zombie eating my face off. Now, before we go to sleep, I don't know who was building this. Now, it looks like this is some sort of a dock for the airship right here. Now, it is very well made. It looks like an old type of rusted, old, dirty, dilapidated, I almost said decapitated, but it's not really decapitated. I gotta wake up, Lemon. Wake up. It's actually later than I should have gotten up a long time ago, but I overslept last night. Anyway, we won't talk about that. I was playing video games until 4 in the morning. Anyway, so yeah. Hello, kitty. I know. I'm trying to record. He wants attention. That's all. That's all. That's okay. So I don't know who built this. Or if I can really use this for anything. I was originally thinking of making a deck or a platform such as this to come out under these little things or somehow like that. But those are not lit up very well. That's okay because we're never gonna be on those. But anyway, and to have some type of a slime thingy to go up inside. But I will need to find out who built this and if they have an idea or what, if they were gonna use this for something or if this is just here. I don't know. I have no idea. I've not had time to watch other videos from Schism or B-Dubs is moving, so he's not been making any flyboys, or me and heavens knows Ty. I don't think Ty did that because Ty has a lot to do, young man. He is making very good progress, but poor Arby. But he's got a lot to do. Good progress, lot to do. I don't know if I'm allowed to show this. And I almost looked right over there at him. I don't know if I'm allowed to show this, but that thing is huge. That thing is gigantic. But let's go ahead and sleep. Let's don't look at this, guys. I don't know whose bed this is. It may be B-Dub's bed, but it's my bed tonight. It's my bed tonight. I don't know who's. I think this is a community bed. And I don't think the sheets have been changed in, good lord, 2 months? Has it been that long? Blech, gross. Hey, Porks, are you guys ever going to do anything? Things are so cool. Too bad they're kind of worthless. I don't even know how to, there's so many things that are around here and changed and moved. And I don't even know where half of this stuff is. Hi, Porks, this is B-Dub's kitchen. It looked like a kitchen on his thumbnail, but it's supposed to be his mad scientist lab. Now this is mad scientisty looking, and this part here kind of looks like a barista. You can go ahead and get some coffee and some frappuccinos and cappuccinos and some nice herbal iced teas. I guess a mad scientist could make some delicious coffee too. That's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. And I left my take-copter on the top. Forgot about that. Luckily, I've got Goaty. Let's go here and get a good takeoff. Good takeoff. Good takeoff. It's like one of those 80s, like, children's cartoon. Like, never mind. Just don't listen to me. Don't listen to anything else to this episode, children. Or old people. All right, now this is actually pretty easy to land on with a goat jet. So, as I say that, I'm gonna crash and burn. No, I did it. I did it, sort of. Right on the cusp of, perfect. That's a perfect landing if I do say so myself. Okay, I got two transportation modes up here. That's okay. Let's go on the inside of this vessel. And we'll take you up to the big main control room, which I may or may not do anything to. I may or may not do anything else to this. I have put some strong boxes in here with some. Of course, we've got swamp boats. How could you not have swamp boats? And I'm gonna put some extra smaller guns just to be on the safe side in here. And we've got some supplies for reloading ammunition and some backup wool and some other stuff for damages that could happen. And probably will to mobs or myself. Now, I was thinking maybe put like a control, like some computers around here. I don't know if I want to do that. And the reason being is I put so much work into this thing, and it's just going to get completely destroyed. If I get bored one day, I may add, like, some chairs in here and some stuff, but I also kind of want a lot of room in here to move around, to look out these windows, because, I mean, you can actually shoot out here onto the deck and close these windows pretty quickly, which is kind of cool. I like that. You can even kind of defend the prison a little bit, the top of it, the roof of the prison. Like, if anybody lands on the roof, you can defend from in here, and you're pretty safe. This is a very small... Actually, it's kind of a big window, but in my opinion, it's a very small window to be able to shoot through. So I may just leave this open to be able to move in and out and around and take cover and... like that. And I had how they do like the 360 like maneuver rolling thing. I you can't do that in Minecraft, but in my head I can. In my head I'm an action hero. And here's the last part here that has the two guns. Machine guns, and they are loaded. Yes, they are loaded. Of course they're loaded. They have a nice 360 degree view, which is wonderful to have. And you can also go up to the very tip top up here, do a little sniping action if you would like, which is really nice. I don't know if you can get on these things. You can't, but you get up here, which is really cool. Can I get up here and you can do some sneaky sniping. And there, everyone, is the airship. I hope you guys like it. I had a great time. You know what? This build for me, let's do up close and personal here. This build was a first, one-of-a-kind build. I have never built anything like this, ever. Ever. And I've been playing Minecraft since early alpha. Like, before, I was playing Minecraft when the only thing there were was, like, grass and trees. I've been playing Minecraft for a long time, and this is the very first build, like a militarized navy type of build ever. And I am really happy with how this turned out. I hope you guys like it. I think this is going to be fun. A fun thing to be on, to play during the final battle. I think it's going to be really fun and exciting. Hope you guys like it. And this is not up close and personal. There we go. This is not going to be the end. I am building more. Now, I don't know if you guys remember, but I was saying that the blue team, they would never reach the airship, the SS Pink Lemonade, and they're not. They will never even get close. And I wasn't just saying that to say it. I said it because I meant it. Because I am not done building, people. I am not, don't hit that thing. I think they'll pop right off of there. I am not done building. I have something made in creative. Actually, a lot of things made in creative with the same style as this airship that will keep the blue team from even coming close. I am so excited. I'm just going to sit here. I'm just going to stand right here and watch as their airships, their flying helicopters, their jets come flying in and just get destroyed one by one, and I will sit here and I will laugh with Schism and Tie Designs and B00, and we will all win the battle, and we will all go out to afterwards, and we'll have a nice sit down drink at O'Charlie's. I mean, not O'Charlie's, I've not been in O'Charlie's in years, or Applebee's, or some fine establishment such as that, and we will talk of our good times and our battle win, and we'll all be friends happily ever after, and that will be the end of this season. It'll be grand. It'll be grand and glorious. But until then, guys, until then, we have... Whoops, that pipe's not done. Just ignore that. Just go right down here. There, you guys can't see that now. Until then, there's still work to be done on the Flyboy server, and I hope to see every single one of you guys until the end of the season. Thanks so much for watching. As always, it's Admiral Lemon. Don't forget to hit that like button if you liked it. send me some comments my way. Let me know if you love the airship and don't comment on things that aren't finished because I'll fix the last 0.005%, I swear. Thanks guys for watching as always. I'll see you later. Bye-bye. That's the wrong view. Yeah, that's the wrong view too. That's the right view. I know how to play Minecraft. Early alpha, I swear. I swear. Sand. Okay, well, that was a big explosion. Okay, that was not expected. That was a big explosion in the... Yeah.